Attempt of the mind to catch hold of itself, which is what we call thinking, worrying. So we could say loosely, yoga is the cessation of thinking. It's not the cessation of awareness, but of symbolizing, trying to touch reality in terms of thoughts, symbols, descriptions, definitions. Give it up. Not easy because we do it habitually. But until there is silence of the mind, it is almost impossible to understand eternal life, that is to say, eternal now. If you could come to the place where you suspend conception. Conceptions in Sanskrit are called vikalpa, and so the state is called nirvikalpa, not conceptual. And this will be basic to everything I'm going to talk to you about. To understand non-verbal reality, non-conceived reality. What I call substance, tatha. It's really very easy, it's too easy. That's why it's difficult. But that when you are fully aware and not thinking, you will notice some amazing absences. There is no past. Can you hear anything past, incidentally? Can you hear anything future? They're just not there to the plain sense of one's ears. Ears are easiest to begin with. Can you hear anyone listening to something else other than sound, you know? Can you hear the listener? No? Well, then presumably it's not there. Then you become again as a child and simply forget all that you ever were told and contemplate what is. All these ghosts go away. That's weird. But they just go. And then you enter into the eternal state. Well, there's no problem. Well, then you go back and you collect your opinions again. You think, well, that won't do. How can I be practical and be in that sort of state? Well, I remember in the Sermon on the Mount that Jesus said a lot of things about this. Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet, Suleiman in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. And if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, faithless ones? Wow. So, do not worry about tomorrow, saying, what shall we eat, what shall we drink, or how shall we clothe ourselves? All the rabble seeks after these things. Sufficient to the day is the worry of it. Nobody ever preaches a sermon on that text. Never. I've heard lots of sermons. Never one on that one. Because people say, look, that's all very well because Jesus was the boss's son.
And he knew, you see, that he was really in charge of the universe. And he's nothing to worry about. But we have to be practical. Oh? What do you suppose the gospel was? The good news. You know, it never got out.